What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and in this video, I want to talk about if Cyberpunk 2077 will be better than The Witcher 3. Now, this kind of brings about it a couple of really cool discussion opportunities, right, that I kind of even hinted at in last week's video. So remember, last week we talked about if the game was going to live up to the hype, if you know, all the expectations, basically, that have been put on this game are actually going to be reached when it comes out. And that kind of does lead us to, well, where are the comparisons? What are we comparing this to? What bar does it need to reach? And what? How good does this game basically need to be to satisfy people? And that leads us, I think, to The Witcher 3. Is that the gold standard? So we're going to talk about all that in this video. Really quickly, if you guys have liked these Cyberpunk videos, and there will be many, many more over the next couple weeks, and then when the game comes out, even more then, make sure you guys are leaving this video a like, make sure you guys are subscribed, bell icon, all that stuff. All of my social media stuff is in the description below if you guys want to join our Discord. We got lots of people there talking about pretty much everything. I'm sure the Cyberpunk conversations will start coming very, very soon, okay? So I think that The Witcher 3 is a reasonable expectation of what people are thinking that this game, you know, can kind of reach. I don't know if it's entirely fair to say, okay, I'm going in expecting The Witcher 3 in this cyberpunk world, and if it doesn't reach that, well, this game isn't as good. This game flat out is going to be different. And I mean, CD Projekt Red, I feel like, has set the stage. I think they've honestly done a really good job at that, of setting or leveling, we could even say, expectations of saying, hey, you know, we are the developers that made it, but we're making this game, and this game is very, very different, and this game is gonna feel different, and this game is gonna look different, and I think that's important. I really do. I think that when we look at open world games, the reason why I do think it's a fair comparison, I don't necessarily think there's all that much wrong with it, is Witcher 3, I think, is oftentimes looked at as like the best open world game of all time. I look at it as that. I look at it as when I think of an open world and I want an open world game to feel like it's being lived in. That's the biggest thing to me. I think, like, even when I talk about Ghost of Tsushima, I love that world. The one thing that I feel like that world is missing, okay? I think the time period in terms of, like, the feudal Japan, I think it's perfect. I think of the environment and what's going on, even, like, the story missions and all that stuff, I think it's perfect. But one of the weaknesses is it doesn't really feel populated. It doesn't really feel like things are happening in the island when I'm not there or when I'm not in a specific area. Witcher, to me, is that gold standard where when I think of games that everything feels alive, and if I'm leaving an area, I know that there's still going to be stuff going on in that area. Witcher 3 is one of those. Is actually the game, actually, I would say, that I think of. So when I think, I can tell you my own opinion, when I think of Cyberpunk 2077, I will tell you flat out honestly, I don't think I'm going to be comparing it to Witcher 3. The only thing I will compare it to Witcher 3 is the world building. How well do they build the world? They've talked about the different districts and how they're going to be very, very different, but also they're going to be very interconnected, and it's going to work, in their words, right, it's going to work like as well as it possibly can. That is what I'm going to be comparing, because Witcher 3, again, it nailed that. I think above all else, I would honestly say, I mean, the story, the characters, stuff like that, but I would say the thing that impressed me the most about Witcher was how big it was, but how everything had purpose. Every character had purpose. Every side quest had purpose. Every optional thing you could do in this game had purpose. And you always felt like the world was moving. It always felt like something was happening in the world. Those are the features that I want in Cyberpunk 2077. And when we talk about could it be better than The Witcher 3, in my mind, that is what I will compare. If anything is going to be better or worse, I would say that. Now, yeah, in general, you can say, okay, well, flat out, is the story going to be as good? Are these characters or the side characters or the quest going to be as good? But I think in terms of what's like the most fair, because you could do that, and I think that's fair, but in terms of what is the most fair, I would go so far to say that is the most fair, that I will probably directly be comparing those four or five things, all the things that I just said, that is what I will be comparing to The Witcher 3 when the game comes out. And to go over a couple of quick predictions, by the way, I think it's very possible this game beats a lot of that. I think what Witcher 3 has to its advantage, or had to its advantage, is that it was part of an established world. But with that being said, the odd and funny thing is, The Witcher games continue to get better and more popular as time went on, but and Witcher 2 was a point where a lot of people jumped in, but Witcher 3 was the main point. So many people, as you can tell by sales, as you can tell tell just from the internet at large, that was the first Witcher game for, I would argue, probably 60 to 80% of the Witcher, you know, fan base. I would say that was the first game. So while it did have an advantage of being part of an established property, it kind of didn't, because most people that jumped, including myself, by the way, now I had watched my friend play The Witcher 2. I had known about The Witcher, but in terms of getting my hands and playing the game, Witcher 3 was the first one, okay? I mean, I watched a lot of The Witcher 2, but Witcher 3 was the first time I played it. So I think that they kind of even out in that regard, and I think Cyberpunk has a good chance that even though it's a brand new world, right, even though it's based off of other things, I feel like it has a lot to its advantage. I like the kind of steampunk world, what they're trying to do with, you know, just the world at large. I think they have a really solid foundation. The visuals aside, visuals, they're a little bit more difficult to compare. It's not even necessarily fair to do something like that, right? But they've been working on this game for like 7 years. Witcher 3 obviously came out over 5 years ago. I mean, obviously you expect this game to look better, but it's things with the quest. It's things with the story. And again, to go back before I lose my train of thought, which I do quite often, what I am impressed about from what we've all seen is that, yeah, every place in this game does seem very, very detailed. And going back to the whole world populated thing, you know, Witcher 3 was very big. They've even said how this world, Cyberpunk's world, is smaller than The Witcher 3, but it's more condensed. It's more filled with things. And honestly, I feel like that's going to work really, really well, because we've seen from the gameplays, we've seen from the trailers. I mean, there are things constantly, the little details everywhere you look are constantly happening. And I think that is very, very special. And I think, yeah, kind of condensing it down into a smaller area is actually really, really going to help it. But again, you know, I know people will say, you know, sometimes I get myself too excited. I get that actually a lot. I also get people that say I get too, critical, or I get too worried about a game before. I'm really, you know, for some reason I can be all of these things, even though it's kind of very contradictory to be both of them. I get that. Where I stand with Cyberpunk is, again, I do think those key facets of the game, I think, can be better than The Witcher 3. The story, stuff like that, people will compare it to The Witcher 3, I think, simply because it's CD Projekt Red. Would it be the most fair thing in the world? Ultimately, no. And the biggest question I even have, and you guys can answer this in the comments too, when we talk about if this game can be better, well, if all of the things I said, so the world building, the side quest, the everything having meaning, it feeling populated, if all of that is better, but the story is worse, which one do we give it to? You know, do we say, well, The Witcher 3 story is better? That ultimately, I think, goes down to the person. Now, I'm a Witcher fan, and I appreciate the story, and I appreciate the lore, and I love that kind, I love the direction, basically, Witcher is in, or like the medium Witcher is in, okay? But I will say, again, my own personal opinion is, in open world games like this, I tend to put more credit, or I put more value towards those other things, towards the actual world itself, rather than the story. I mean, the story needs to be powerful. It needs to actually be, you know, at least solid, right? At the very least solid. But I think if Cyberpunk 2077 beats Witcher on all of those smaller details, world building side things, I feel like, to me, that kind of gives it a leg up, even if the story, say, isn't as good, because again, it's the first game, we're just jumping in, stories, they're not one-to-one, right? Can we necessarily compare one story to the other, especially if they're in two completely different, yes, they're both open world games, but they're completely different genres of open world games, right? So that becomes more difficult. So ultimately, and with a lot of the videos that I end up doing, it's personal opinion. It just comes down to what you think of the, the property or the whatever specific aspect of whatever we're talking about, right? So that's how I view it. I definitely want to hear how you guys view it in the comments below. So let me know. Let me know any other kinds of Cyberpunk 2077 videos you want to see. Like I said, I'll be doing a few more. I'll try to do at least one a week, maybe more, as we, you know, go over the next couple weeks. And then when the game comes out, I'll be covering it. We'll live stream it. We'll have tons of different stuff on this game once the game releases, okay? Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all on the next video.